I'm Sarah Brown. The exhibition is called Remote. I live in Alice Springs in the middle of the desert, in the middle of Australia, and spend a lot of time travelling and working in remote communities. So there's 45 works in this collection, and they're some of my favourite places to be. I was born in England and came to Australia when I was 6. I started painting when I was a teenager and had my first show in Queensland on my 16th birthday. I painted totally differently to this. I did pen and ink watercolours. But I had 3 or 4 exhibitions in Queensland that put me through uni. I didn't have to have a day job in a supermarket. And then for about 10 years, I was a remote area nurse out bush and had 3 little kids. So for 10 years, I did lots of looking at the country that I was living in, but I didn't have the opportunity to paint because I was on call for people all the time. So I arrived in Alice Springs in 2004, actually 2003, and decided I'd have a go at painting again, and it all just kind of went out of me. All these memories of country and 10 years of not painting mean that now when I'm at home, I paint every day. And there's something wrong if I'm not painting. So since 2004, I've had about 8 exhibitions, mainly in Alice Springs, Canberra and Darwin. So this is my first international exhibition. I live in an extraordinary part of the world. The desert is, lots of people will think of desert as being just red dirt and not much else, or sand dunes, but it's an incredibly rich place. And there's also these great strong colours and big skies. So every time I step out my front door, I've got inspiration. The process is, I tend to paint in acrylics, either on canvas or on board. And I usually start with the canvas or board completely red. So I start with an under colour of red and then start building up from that. I only use primary colours, I only buy red, blue, yellow and white. And so I mix all the colours from that. So that helps, I think, if you look around the room, that there's every paint is different, but there's a common thread. And part of that is the same colour palette. So I'm mixing each colour as I'm using it. So a small board will take me a couple of hours. Often I'll let them sit for a while and finish them off later. And the bigger canvases can take 1 to 2 weeks really, because I have a day job too. So I'm often working on a few paintings at a time, and if I'm getting ready for an exhibition, I'll have a number of paintings that are like 3/4 done. I try really hard not to overwork them, so you'll see skies where you can still see quite a bit of the red through the sky. That helps to show kind of storms coming and the drippy wetness of the clouds. So I don't want to lose that. So for me, often deciding when to stop can be significant. I work, I run an Aboriginal organisation, and I've worked on Aboriginal communities and with Aboriginal health services for about the last 25 years. And that has influenced not only my life, but of course my painting. I think it's really interesting when I travel out to country with dialysis patients. I'm seeing the light and the shapes and the forms, and they're seeing the country in a totally different way. They're seeing the storylines and the sacred sites and the good hunting places. So I love the fact that we see that country in totally different ways, but at the same time, I've got a great appreciation for country and how important it is to people and how important it is to help people to stay on their country, to look after it. Palyantjaku, Tjutaku Aboriginal Corporation, which is why people call us the Purple House. Pintupi people from the Western Desert, so right out near the West Australian border and over into Western Australia, were really worried about their family members who had to leave their homes and their country to come to Alice Springs for dialysis. So their kidneys were failing and they needed dialysis treatment three times a week. And that meant leaving their family and their country and everything important to them to come to be close to a hospital. And people were really suffering. And there was a real danger that Pintupi painters wouldn't be able to paint the beautiful pictures and they wouldn't be able to pass on their cultural heritage to their kids and their grandkids. So they got together with Papanyushula artists and Sotheby's Auction House and Hetty Perkins from the Art Gallery of New South Wales. And they painted some big collaborative paintings. They had an auction at the Art Gallery of New South Wales in November 2000. And in one night they raised over $1 million. So the Kirikura men's painting sold for $340,000, one painting. So this gave people $1 million of independent money to try to see if they could get people home on dialysis. And they asked me to help them. So I've been doing that since 2003. So it's grown. We started with a little house in Alice with one machine in the back bedroom and one machine out in Kintore. And we started to get people home. And then other communities asked for help. And we're now 24 dialysis machines in 11 places. And we're in the Northern Territory and Western Australia. We're right up to Arnhem Land and down to Warburton in Western Australia. And next year, we're planning to build our first South Australian dialysis unit in Ernabella or Pukacha. So it's a great example of Aboriginal people really working hard to make life better for themselves and for their family members and sharing that knowledge to help other communities. So it's a real honour to have been involved. The Purple Track, we realised that although we were growing and getting permanent dialysis with nurses in more communities, that it was going to be really hard to have dialysis clinics and nurses, houses and staff in every little community that people really need to be back at. And so we thought, well, why don't we design a truck that can go anywhere and then it can give people an opportunity to get home, even if it's just for a while. So if you imagine, if you're stuck in Alice Springs and your country is 12 hours drive away on really rough roads, and there's no dialysis there, you really haven't got any hope of ever getting home. So what we can do with the truck is that we can tell people the truck's going to Docker River for a month in June, would you like to come? And that immediately gives people something to look forward to and work towards. Their families will get ready for them returning for the month and they'll make sure that they go to all their appointments and stay really well so they can get home. So we built this purple track. We got philanthropic support to build it. It's got beautiful paintings, Papanyushula paintings by major Peninsula artists were also on dialysis that were in a show in New York in 2009. We don't have any government funding for the truck, so we raise money ourselves. And it's on the road about 9 months of the year. We park it up when it's 45 degrees in Alice Springs because it's just too hard to keep people cool enough. But it's been great because it's ours and we can take it wherever people want to go. And it gives people real hope about getting home. And it also, we're still going to communities where there's never been dialysis machines before. So people are really proud they're getting the machines back and their family members back. And so that's a great opportunity to talk to community about how to keep your kidneys healthy and to demystify dialysis so it's not so scary. So people will start making a concerted effort to make sure they don't need to end up on dialysis. We depend on people being our friends. We love to hear from people who just want to know the Purple House story and help in some way. For some people that's making a tax deductible donation. For other people they come and volunteer at the Purple House and get to spend some time with some of our patients. For some people it's just liking our Facebook page and watching the stories. For our directors, my bosses, they're just thrilled that people from other places take an interest in their story. They're really proud of what they've achieved and they love to share it. And they also love to find ways to help other people to understand the issues for Aboriginal people and Aboriginal communities and like being a good news story in Aboriginal health. So the Purple Truck has a Facebook page and if you like that, we'll love you forever. But you can also follow the adventures of the Purple Truck. And for people who are coming to Alice Springs, then everyone's really welcome to call into the Purple House and have a cup of tea. And if you're lucky, we might even cook you a kangaroo tail.